Squirrels are not going to hunt you down in packs, are they?
My name is Megan Ruth. I'm a Canadian living in London, England, and I react to British things. So today I'm going to be reacting to some more Al Murray. I'm going to be reacting to Al Murray versus Americans. I love teasing Americans sometimes, you know, it's fun. Having said that, I do have some American friends and family members, and they are all lovely people. So this is all in jest. Let's just get started, shall we?
You're beautiful. You're beautiful people. Have we got anyone from overseas here tonight? Anybody from overseas? Yeah? Fabulous. From which vanquished nation do you hail, sir? Tell me. Where are you from?
United States.
United States. Fantastic. Welcome, mate. Welcome. I love you people. What's your name, Squire?
Neil.
Neil! Beautiful British name. Now, Neil. Tell me. Neil, how long have you been in Great Britain, Squire?
2 weeks.
2 weeks. Yeah? Yeah? Tell me, if you had to sum up Great Britain in one word, Neil, what would it be, mate? Come on. Come on, Neil. Shit will get off the pot, sir. You what?
Football.
No. The word you're looking for, mate, is great, isn't it? Clues in the name, for fuck's sake. Those are yank. No, I love Americans. They're beautiful people, aren't you? Yeah? Yeah, you're beautiful people. Because the world, no, I love them. Huh? Back off, I love them. I love them, I love Americans. Because the world needs people like Americans, don't they? Because you're dreamers, aren't you? Yeah? Yeah? You're dreamers, aren't you, Neil? Yeah? Because you've got that American dream. The American dream. Yeah? You're an American dreamer. Dreaming the American dream, aren't you, Neil? Yeah? Yeah? Now, the fact is, Neil, we don't have a dream in Great Britain. We don't. There is no British dream. Yeah. This isn't because we lack some sort of sense of moral purpose. This isn't because we haven't got a sense of guiding destiny taking us towards a better tomorrow. No, we don't have a dream in this country, Neil, because we're awake. That's simple. What is that dream of yours anyway? Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Hey, I'd be embarrassed to write that down if I were you, Squire. It's a pleasure to have you here, you're beautiful bloke. I love Americans, you're beautiful people. Yeah? You're simple folk, aren't you? If an American can't explain something, he says he's aliens, isn't he? Well, at least British people are prepared to admit when they're pissed, Neil. I mean, we're sensible people in this country. This is a reasonable country. It's a reasonable size, isn't it? Great Britain isn't that big, yeah? America's vast, isn't it? Far too big, unwieldy country, yeah? Britain's compact, yeah? You reasonable size. I mean, the mountains aren't exactly that big, are they? Yeah? They're big enough to learn how to climb mountains and then practice and conquer other peoples. They're not that big in themselves. I mean, the wildlife is not particularly wild, is it? Squirrels are not going to hunt you down in packs, are they? We don't have earthquakes in this country, do we? No, because we don't deserve them, it's that simple. Anyone who builds a city on a thing called the San Andreas Fault really has got it coming. The fact is, Neil, it's not San Andreas' fault, is it? It's yours for building it there in the first place. Classic, classic, classic American behaviour, trying to palm the blame off onto some poor fucking Mexican. We're sensible, down-to-earth people in this country. Aren't we? Yes, Steve?
Oh, we are.
Here we are. Could you play God Save the Queen? Yeah? F-F. G.
D-E-F.
G-G.
A.
G.
G.
F-D.
D.
E.
F-G.
A. C. Now, the point is this. The point is this. You might have been stupid, eh? The point is this. The point is this. We're sensible, down-to-earth people in this country, aren't we? Hmm? This is a sensible, down-to-earth country. I mean, we never put a man on the moon, did we? No! No! What would be the fucking point? Hey? New Yanks, you're banging about how you got there first, but no one else was trying, were they, mate? Hmm? count. Doesn't matter who comes first when you're on your own, does it, ladies and
gentlemen? Oh my God.
It's been a year. I mean, we're sensible people in this country, don't we? Down to earth people. Yeah, we never put man on the moon. Nah, the moon was never going to be part of the British Empire, was it, by chance? Nah, there's no one to give it back to once we're done with it, was it? There's no point going to the moon, putting in a railway trial by jury, parliamentary democracy. There's no bastard living there, is there? That's the trip. There's nothing to be gained in the way of hot and spicy food or Olympic quality athletes. It's a waste. A journey. I mean, why would the British, the very people who invented gravity, want to go somewhere where there isn't any, hey? Doesn't make any sense at all. Now, the moon should be left to its own business of tides, werewolves, and periods. No. If anyone can explain to me the actual difference between them last two, changed all later. Now, the point is this. One man's silver bullet is another woman's bar of chocolate. period, Neil. That's an example of a word that means different things to you and I, isn't it? It's quite. Because you're a Yank and I'm British, yeah? That's right. Period, yeah? To the American woman, the word period probably means something like full stop, doesn't it? That's the same thing for American geezers, eh, Neil? Because we're divided by a common language, that's right, and a fucking great big ocean, thank Christ. The point is this.
God, you know what? I'm so grateful that is a character, because that character is poking fun on a certain type of demographic. And I love it. It's brilliant. Something that I noticed as well, he was doing that off the cuff, because he wouldn't have known that there was an American in his audience unless he was a plant. He would have had to do that all off the cuff, which is great. Like, amazing. Brilliant. I love how he had a set as well. Like, the bar and the beer. It made it a little bit more evident that he was playing a character. But even so, it's still so believable. It's still so beautifully crafted. And you would think that he was a real person. You know, that was a real person up there, not someone playing a character. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the reaction. Before I go, I just want to quickly shout out my patrons. Thanks to my patrons for supporting me. My Patreon is my members only site where you get benefits such as early access to my videos and my complete unedited uncensored reaction videos. And patron shoutouts if you're a top tier patron. So thank you to Joseph, Brian, Reese, Kane, Robin, Hypno, Bob, Emil, Julian, Steve, Patrick, Sean, Hikers, 1980, RG, Rob, William, Ian, Kyle, Danny, Tanner, Rob, DW, Gary, Bud, and Raul. Thanks again for watching and see you next time. Bye!